Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, this is the World of Wayne. We've now got issue 27, which is stages 99 to 102 of the Hero Collector and Eagle Moss release of Build the Ecto-1. Now as you can see, we're getting there. We've got the lighting sorted out now, and if you look at the desktop here, I've actually got the lighting sorted out there as well. I've only got two cameras on the go at the moment. No, I've got three cameras. We should have five when I get my camera mounts, which should be coming today. But if you remember in the last issue, issue 26, we finished off doing the right rear door. We're going to be finishing that in this issue, and then we're going to be doing the back hatchback door as well, which we do have a little bit of a problem with the Ecto-1 logo, the Ghostbusters logo, a little bit on the wonk. So I will show you that when we get to it. But without further ado, let's get cracking. So to start with, just like last time, we have got the parts for the door, the winder and the handle, and we've also got the mechanism in place here for the window. So the first thing we need is the door handle, looking just like that. Bring over the door card from the last stage. As you can see, this has got a little keyhole pattern on the end, and that's just going to go in like this, held in with an EP screw. So I've got that here, and we'll just attach that. No problems at all. Now, as you see, we've already done the mechanics in here for the window mechanism. What we're going to be doing now is putting the handle in, which is going to control the window going up and down like that. Now, if you look at this handle on the top camera, you can see that it's not actually a circle. It's sort of like a semicircle. And the cog that we're going to need is the one that matches that shape. The other cog that you get is round. So that's how you know what cog you're actually using. But what we do is we can just put this in any way we want. And we're going to be putting the first cog on, which has the shape of that handle there. So I'm just going to rotate that round until it fits on. Just like that. And that's going to be held in with a KM screw. Now the KM screws are flange screws. And you will have noticed that it ends in an M. And that's because the handle here is metal. So I have put that in a little bit of oil just to help me out to get that in. So what I'm looking for is that when I rotate this round, that moves freely there, which means the last cog that we have to put in, looking just like this, goes into the section next to it. We need to make sure that they engage. So when I turn it, everything should turn just like that. And then we're going to be holding that in place with a UP screw. Again, the UP screws are flanged, but it ends in a P. So I'm not going to put that in any oil. So that's that one on. Again, I just want to make sure we've got movement on there. Absolutely fine. I'm actually going to set it up to around about there because we're going to be putting the window in now. Now, if you have a look at the slot on the window, it's slightly off center. So we want to make sure that the larger section here is pointing towards this side of the door. So that's going to go in just like that. We're going to hold that in once again with a UP screw. So line that up. Put that in and make sure that's on there. You don't want it to be on too tight because we do want that to be able to move quite freely in there like that. Now we're going to be attaching this whole thing to the door, which means I am going to use my Partworks upgrade mat to keep the door from scratching. I've got that here. I'm surprised things have survived the move and I haven't broken anything yet. But there you go. So that's the part here. And I think the hardest bit of this is just actually just lining it up. So put this on top, have a little jiggle around till it fits in. And you know what? I think, just having a look here, that's not too far off. You want to make sure when you put the window in, the mirror, it goes underneath these tabs here. So I'm just going to put that in first. That will help line it up like that. Then I can put the top over on both sides, and there we go, that's in. I'm just going to check the window goes up and down, which you see, it's working absolutely perfect. But before I do that completely, I am going to want to secure that in. That's secured in with IP screws on the top two holes there, and then DM screws on the bottom two. So here's the first IP screw in. And here's the second one. So they're both in, and then just the two DM screws. Going into metal, so a little bit of oil just to help me out. That's the first one. And there's the second one. So that door is now complete. I'm just gonna put the window up, show you on camera here, completely now, all the way. And there we go, that's the finished door. Now, before we can attach that to the vehicle, I'm gonna bring that over and just put the electrics in for the door catch. Now, in traditional World of Wayne fashion, I forgot to put the door trims on, which are two really thin pieces of chromed plastic that need to go inside the door card. So you wanna make sure that you do that. But here's a picture of mine installed. Okay, I've brought the car up, which was really hard work, and I've taken out this switch here, which is labeled X. It's got this on the end there. This is going to be going into this section here. Now the way it goes is with this pointing this way round, and we're just going to be putting it in there like that. We're going to trace this lead round, so it's going to go this way, then up and M round. Now to keep that in place, we have got this little tab here that's just going to go onto this side like this, and that's going to hold that into place. We're going to be putting that in with HM screws. So that's that. Then we've got the door catch here to put on, which looks like that. That's just going to go into this section. Oh, clumsy hands. Just like that, held in with one DM screw. Again, I have put that in a little bit of oil. And that is all the way in. Just wrap that wire around there at the moment. I'll probably put a little bit of tape in there in a minute just to keep that into place, because I don't want it to be catch on anything and break, which has already happened to one of my wires. Which means all we've got to do is turn this really heavy thing over, ready to attach the door. So just like last time, we're going to be taking the door hinge here and attaching that through the panel that we can see here. It's going to hold it into place. It's going to open this door to help me with that. So that's in fine. I'm going to try and shut the door to keep that in place. And then the HM screws, I will just put in a little bit of oil with my hands and then put the screw just into the hole, ready to screw that up. Here's the second one. That goes in there, and then I'll just tighten them up. And there we go, that's in. I'll turn it over. We'll check the operation of the door, which as you can see, opens and closes. No problems at all. Excellent. Now, of course, in typical World of Wayne fashion, I completely forgot to put the door barrel in, which looks like this. So I'm gonna get that in now. And as you can see, that's in perfectly, and that definitely is all there is to do in that stage. Now, I'm glad we're doing this one. This is stage 100. We're gonna be doing the right rear window frame and the skirting for it. And I know a lot of people been having problems, oh, let's get this out, I seem to be stuck in my one, applying this skirting to this corner here so that it sticks. So I'm going to show you how to do that a lot more slower this time so you can follow along. Now, the first one we're actually going to be putting in is the one just on this bend here, which is just going to go in like this. And I'm going to line up the bottom on this section for this trim. Fold it round, and that's gone in absolutely perfect, as you can see there and on the close-up. Now we're going to be putting the long piece in. Now we know it's going to be going in absolutely fine on this side here, but we are going to have a problem when it comes around to this bend here, because we want this to fold around. Now to get that fold, it's always going to spring up. To actually make sure that doesn't happen, we need to use something called a former. Now for me, I'm just going to use my hammer here. And all a former is, it's going to be making a curved edge for you. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start wrapping this around my former here, like this. Now, you probably would have seen me do this when I did the Metal Earth models. You see? And you want to make sure it's way more than you need. A lot more than you need, as you can see there. I'll show you on the close-up. So now, when I put this on, it's going to want to stay down by itself without any glue, which I will demonstrate for you, as you can see. See? It wants to stay down all by itself. No clamps, no nothing. So what I'm going to do is take the adhesive off, and I'll show you how that looks when it's done. If you wrap it around the former first, again, more than you actually need, it should keep itself into place. Just like that. Working my way along here on this trim panel. That looks perfect. There you go. And as you can see, that's a perfect corner done. And there's no extra super glue needed or anything like that. That holds itself into place. No problems at all. So it means the last one we've got to do is just a bit of trim down this side. I've got that here. Put that right close to the edge there. Put that into place. And there we go. That's that window done. That's all there is to do in that stage. Now, as you can see, in stage 101, we've got the windows for that frame we've just done. So I'm going to bring the vehicle back over. We'll get these installed. Now, what makes me laugh is I keep forgetting things. And to start this stage, we do have to put this center trim panel down, which I only remembered right at the end of the build. Now, this is going to be a little bit tricky to show you this, but what I want to do is put the windows just into this side here. So I've got one there, and I'll put the second one in this side. And then all of that's going to be held in with the frame that we've just made, which is going to sit into these cavities here. Now, they're going to be held in just at the bottom here, first off, with some VM screws. Once again, these are metal screws, so I have put them in a little bit of metal. So there's the first one. Don't worry too much if the windows do come loose. Just reattach them. And that's all the bottom sides put in. And now I'm just going to piece the top sides in, just into the holes here with screws from the inside. So I put an AP screw in here. The ones on this post here take VP screws. These are longer ones. So into the bottom hole, not the top one. And there you go. When that's in, it should look just like that. And that's all there is to do in that stage. So now, the last stage, stage 102, we've got the rear door. Now, this is going to be a quick stage, but we do need to talk about some things. Namely, that I do love the way that Eagle Moss have actually now put the stickers on for us. Like they promised in stage one, no problems at all. Can you see the problem there, though? That it's actually tilting too far this way. So if I'm looking at it now, it is really apparent. Now, I have got replacement stickers from Mike Lane Mods, and I'll put that at the bottom of the screen there, and also Partwork Upgrades. They do replacement stickers as well. My plan is not on this video today, but I am going to take this sticker off, clean down the surface, and just replace it with the other sticker, make sure it's on the right way. I'm not quite sure why it's been put that way, but I've already had a lot of emails about how wonky these badges are put on. But you know what, it is what it is. So I'm going to leave it like that just for this video, but just to make you aware of that, and just to let you know there are avenues out there if you do want to change that for yourself. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to be taking the door handle here, looking like that. And that's just going to go into the holes here. Turn it upside down. It's going to be held in with an AM screw, just like this. Make sure that's in nice and tight. And then the last thing we're going to do is put the hinge into place, and that's going to be going this way round. Make sure it goes over these two lugs here, just like that. That's going to be held in with these flanged RM screws, Once again, metal, bit of oil, and that's going to help drive that in. That's one. And here's the second one. Nice and tight. There you go. That's the rear hinge on at the moment, and that's all there is to do in that stage. So we've done all the windows, almost all the doors in the vehicle. We're just going to be working on this one. I don't know if that's going to make a difference. It's quite bright, this light is at the moment, so you can't really see it on that one, but you can see that the ghost is slightly off center. To be honest with you, I preferred if I had my own sticker and put it on myself, but it is what it is. Now, if you want to get this for yourself, and let me just tell you now, this car weighs a ton. I had to get it down from the man cave into the new workshop. It almost killed me. But if you want to get this for yourself, put the link down here. If you're in the UK, follow the UK link. If you're in the US, follow the US link. You'll be able to get this all the way from pack one. Anyway, listen, thank you for watching this. If you like this video, please remember to give me a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.